So a lot of people have asked me sort of like, how do you pay for a mommy makeover? Because they are very, very costly, or even just like one of the procedures if you wanted to do it. I did a lot of research into the financing options. Like, full disclosure, I did pay for my surgery in cash in full. I didn't end up needing any financing options. However, with that said, I still researched what was sort of involved, because I was curious actually as to whether or not there was a 0% financing option, because if there was, I would have totally taken it and kept that money in the bank, that extra period of time interest free. It turns out that I personally could not find any 0% financing options for a mommy makeover. I know when I did my laser eye surgery a couple of years ago with Bochner Eye Institute out of Toronto, through Medicard Financial, I was able to get 0% financing for 1 year on the $5,000 that my eye surgery costed. And once again, although I had the money to pay for it in full, why not take free financing for a year and keep that money in the bank a little longer? But unfortunately, when I reached out to Medicard for this particular surgery, they said, you know, the financing of 0% comes at a clinic level on whether or not they'll actually offer that. And apparently, Dr. Kara's office does not have that arrangement for 0% financing. I don't know of any other plastic surgeons that actually do offer that. It could exist. If you find one, comment below and let us know. But from what I saw, you know, the different clinics, they do offer financing options at a clinic level as well as through a third party. However, it's not financing post surgery. So in reality, you're actually financing and prepaying for your surgery before actually having your surgery. So let's say you want to start now making monthly payments towards a surgery you're going to have in a year or 2 years from now. Of course, the doctor's office is going to take your money and start saving it aside for you if you'd like. I don't know that that's necessarily a good idea, because you're basically giving your money to someone else to hang on to when you could probably just do that yourself if you're disciplined enough, and furthermore could probably invest it in a way to make you more money temporarily. But I'll leave that with you and your banker to discuss. But yeah, I mean, if you're really keen on disciplining yourself to budget that money aside, you could start a payment plan with your surgeon's office directly to sort of prepay for your surgery before you actually have it. From what I see, there is no such thing as a surgeon's office who will let you have the surgery and then pay for it. I've never seen that before. Your other option is to obtain financing through a third party, which would be one of the other third party financing companies that your surgeon's working with. So my surgeon worked with Medicard as well as another third party financing. However, when I called them to inquire about the financing rates, in my opinion, they were ridiculously expensive. And I mean, I have really good credit, and they told me that the starting financing rate was like 7.9%, which is crazy. Like, right now, like, mortgage rates are like less than 2%, which means that a line of credit rate is usually prime, which is the mortgage rate, plus a percent. So line of credit rates right now should be even like 3%. So to do financing through a medical company starting at 8%, and God forbid you have bad credit, it would probably be even worse than that. To me, didn't make sense. I would never personally do that. So I do highly recommend that if you don't have all the money or any of the money for the surgery and you really want to do it now, you could look at financing it through one of these medical providers. But I would also suggest that if you own a home, like, look at a line of credit option. It'll probably be a lot more affordable. Even a credit card, like, I called some of my credit card companies, and even my credit card rate was cheaper than those financing companies. Like, my TD Visa, if I wanted to use that, it would have been only 4% financing rate on the TD Visa. So once again, double check all your different options, do your research, and see what the best route is for you. Obviously, the best thing to do is actually have the money to be able to pay in cash and do the surgery once you can afford to do it. But I know a lot of us get excited and really want to get it now. So just make sure that you discipline yourself and find the best financing rate so that your surgery doesn't end up costing you a lot more than it already is in financing, and that you can afford the monthly payment, because the last thing you want to do is get yourself into a financial obligation that you can't meet.